Testing. Training. Let's talk training. This is the announcement. I've been training students to fly for roughly 2 years now. I started it out as a per lesson basis, but the more I did it, the more I realized I wanted to go full on with this. So I have built up the school. I've got setups for heavier pilots and lighter pilots. I'm just going to offer it like lifetime training, $1,000. That covers everything. I've got all the gear you need for your initial kiting and initial flights for basically any size pilot, unless you're at the super extreme edges. I mean, if you're a 400-pound guy, I probably don't have the stuff that you need, but any, you know, normal-sized human being that wants to learn to foot launch, I've got gear available to get you all the way through your first tow flights. We do tow flying, tow machine flying, because I'm in Louisiana. That's where the majority of my training is. The school is located roughly based at Spring Hill Airport. I do have numerous locations scattered about the area, also locations in Oklahoma, Texas, and South Louisiana that we can use for training. And the school moves around. A lot of times we go to where the weather's good. I do still have my day job. I do have to squeeze in pharmacy work in between. The way training usually works is if I have students from out of town, I'll schedule the mornings and evenings off from my day job. And if it's flyable, we'll meet up and train when the conditions are right for training. When it's not flyable, we do ground school. So I get a lot of people that come in from out of town to do this training with me. It's different for everybody to say that it's you know, 1 week boot camp, you know, you're gonna show up, never touched anything, and at the end of it, you're gonna know how to fly. Oftentimes, that's a stretch. I see schools advertising it, you know, we've got 10 out of 10 pilots flying at the end of the week. That's a stretch. I don't know if that's just an anomaly. Most classes are not like that, and it depends on the level of student as well. You know, what they put in is what they get out. As an instructor, I simply tell you what you're doing wrong, tell you how to do it right, but it's still up to the student to put in the hard work, and that's just the nature of paramotor training. I bust it up into three phases, basically. The way the school goes is you show up and I teach you how to do ground handling. And we start with a small wing that won't pluck you or hurt you or slam you, and then graduate up to a bigger wing once you learn control. We learn to do reverse inflations, forward inflations, reverse kiting, forward kiting. And when you can transition between all of those moves every time in any condition that's safe, that brings us to phase two, tow flights. We will tow you up. We will have a, you know, lengthy safety discussion about towing, and that's part of the training. How to do it, what to look for, safety concerns. We go through the whole deal, the whole shebang. We start off good conditions. We have to have perfect conditions for towing. If it's anything outside of near perfect, it's not good for first flights. I like to have that tight window. So it varies as to how much of that we get and how much of that we can do. But if you're ready for it, then when it's right, we'll strike. So we do tow flights. We'll get you your first, however many it takes. It varies from 2 to 10. When we get you launching, controlling the wing, doing weight shift, doing oscillation control, good landings without banging your butt or tripping forward or anything like that. Dealing with emergency situations, you know, say the line breaks, the tow machine fails, how you handle things. It's all discussed, it's all trained for, and once you can do tow flights and come down and do beautiful, perfect landings, then you're ready for phase three, which is motor training. The way I do motor training is we will get your unit adjusted properly for you, set it up on the hang station, and go through some throttle exercises. Throttle is very important. You can take a perfect wing and you can wreck it with some nasty throttle inputs. So we really want to focus on that. Get everybody doing their throttle properly, wearing the motor on the ground, kiting with the motor. You know, we get it adjusted, set up, practice getting out of the seat, into the seat. Once all the motor ground, you know, if it needs break in, we'll break in the motor as we do these things. And it's all included. Once you're ready, once you spend some time on the hang station and you're putting in the proper inputs, you're following directions correctly, we make sure the comms are working. That's a big part of it. Once all that is good, then we wait for good conditions for your first motor flights. And we go to wherever it's right for that. And we do motor flying. So, and that's it. After that, then you've got the fundamentals, you've got the basics, you've got the training. You could go practice yourself. And then if at any point you need to come back, or if you want to split the phases up, do phase one, go home, practice, come back, do phase two, go home, practice. Well, can't really practice from phase two. That's tow flying. Unless you have heels around and you can do like baby heel launches, that's awesome way to learn to fly. And then come back for phase three and we can do motor training. So that's kind of the three ways that I do it. And I'm not signed up with the USHPA. I did complete their entire training course as an instructor's course. I have been trained formally by USPPG. Is that it? Jeff Goins thing, whatever that is. The USPPG, whatever. I had formal training with that organization to be an instructor. You know, it seemed that I was doing everything right already. I didn't actually affiliate myself with the organization, so I'm not on that website. But by doing that, I don't have to pay any fees. I still do the training the same way. I follow a steady progression of what you need to be a safe and effective pilot. If you need a rating for whatever reason, there are people out there that will get you those for a very small fee usually. I don't offer ratings, but again, that's not what I'm in it for. I'm able to keep the prices down by not doing that. Pricing. For anything phase one, phase two, $1,000. Phase three varies. If you have your own motor set up, it's still $1,000. Phase three is included. If you need a motor and you are ready to do motor phase three training, I have rentals available. The fee is $1,500. That covers motor. That covers everything. You can use all my gear to train with before you even have to buy anything. And that's for just a $1,500 come and go as often as you please for the remainder of your natural life. As long as I'm doing it, you're in. That's how I'm doing this training. It's not something that you want to fit into a week. I know a lot of people take a week off, come down. Some people are just able to fly at the end of that week, and some people need more. They need to come back and do it again. And that varies from pilot to pilot. I'm going to be straight up honest about it. The people that come in and are able to fly at the end of a 7-day course, if the weather has been good most of those days, is, you know, roughly 50%. I'm just kind of going to throw that number out of there. Some people are really, really close, but they still need to fine tune some things, maybe get some extra tow flights in. And sometimes it's a personal decision. I think they may be ready skill wise, but in their own psyche, they're not ready and they want a little more. And that's fine. Everything is individualized to the pilot and what they need. We talk about the goals. We talk about what's needed to get to those goals. And each pilot has like a training plan that's spelled out, and the progression varies. You know, we don't say you're going to be doing this by then. It's different for everyone. Everyone's different. Everyone picks up skills at different rates. I just want to make myself available, and I don't know how much more I can ramble about it. I just wanted to announce it to the world so that everybody knows where I'm coming from. I've got full setups for light pilots and heavier pilots, and I can teach you anything you need to know about how to fly safely and effectively with a wide variety of gear. I'm not a dealer. I do have some connections with dealers. I can probably get you some mild discounts on gear if you were looking to buy new. Contact me. We'll talk about that. The page. The school page is the Kylo School of Paramotor. That's what I'm calling this setup. Again, the school moves around. It's not a centralized location. It's obviously based here at my home. Again, I like to keep it cheap so that I can pass the savings on to the students. I think that this deal is very fair for what you get. It's a good deal, and it's good for everybody. I have spots available at the end of June, and that's the next spot that I have. So, hey, if you're into that and you want to come and do it, come on. I'm here. The Kylo School of Paramotor will get you what you need to succeed. That sounds corny. I don't really have a tagline. Come on down. I'll teach you how to fly. How about that? Hey, much love, everybody. Kyle out.